peanut dust and corn husk drifting through the air tonight. The marching bands warming up under the football.
Corn harvest is one of the most important events that occurs in the Great Plains of America each year. Corn is the biggest cash crop that farmers grow in the region. Corn harvest is the greatest income that a typical farmer living in the Great Plains will earn. To harvest the corn, farmers use a machine called a combine. These beasts are used to harvest all kinds of crops, including wheat, oats, rye, barley, soybeans, flax, and of course corn. Basically, the way a combine works is there is a header that pulls in all the corn and picks all the ears. The ears then enter the feeder house via the header auger. Once the ear has entered into the feeder house, it goes through a separator that removes the kernels from the cob. The leftover corn plant is then spread out the back by the chaffer. To harvest corn, farmers use a lot of different machines, like the combine, tractor, which is hooked up to a grain cart, and semis, which pull grain trailers. These are all used to get the corn from the field to the elevator in a fast and efficient manner.
Early corn harvesting was a lot more difficult than harvesting wheat and small grains. The stalks are tough and were clogged up machines. In addition, corn has to be very dry to be stored safely, and drying bins had not been developed until the 1940s. Most farmers harvested late in the year when the crop had dried out on the stalk. Most harvested by hand. The ears were broken off the stalk and the husk removed. Then corn was stored on the ear until it was shelled and sold later. In 1930, the Gleaner Baldwin Harvester Company marketed the first corn combine that efficiently harvested the crop. It would be pulled by a 15 to 30 horsepower tractor and was able to pick up roughly 90 to 95% of the corn from the field. But the machine cost roughly $1,600 at the time, a pricey amount in a depression. The problem of the corn moisture being too high remained an issue. The Gleaner Baldwin Company failed because of this. The combine was eventually perfected and was a mainstay for all successful farmers to come.
Each year, many traditions are fulfilled in the harvest field. For the most part, each family farm has their own traditions that have been passed down from generation to generation. The most common of these traditions includes meals being brought out to the field by the farmer's wife, friends and family members coming out to the field to ride on the harvest equipment, and teaching the next generation how to run a successful harvest operation.
These traditions have been passed down through many generations because farmers want their children to learn the traditions and keep them alive. To obtain such strong and important traditions, the next generation of farmers will continually be taught the importance of hard work, determination, and most of all, the youth learn to acquire and build upon strong relationships with their neighbors, friends, and families. Each person involved with corn harvest plays a specific role in the cycle. The cycle begins with the combine driver, who harvests the corn directly from the stalk and then delivers it to the grain cart operator, who transports the grain from the combine to the semi-truck. From the semi-truck, the grain is transported to the grain elevator or the feed yard. From there, the semis are weighed, unloaded, and sent back to the harvest field to get another load. One of these machines is as nearly as important as the operator behind it. If one of these machines breaks down, it stops the whole operation, and it takes every member to contribute to get it back up and running and get the cycle going back again. The best way to learn about corn harvest is to hear firsthand from experienced corn producers who have done this their whole lives. During this upcoming interview, we asked Jay, Jesse, and Jarvis Gerritsen two questions about corn harvest and how it affects them. We asked them, what industries need corn harvest, and what is your favorite position in the harvest field?
Most of the corn we raise is for feed grain for the livestock industry and also for the ethanol industry. There's many other uses for the commercial grade corn that we grow. You find corn in a lot.
You get your hands in it, plant your roots in it, dusty headlight dance with your boots in it.
Probably dealing with the feed yards and keeping the destinations coordinated so the trucks can keep up and hopefully keep the combines from having to stop in the field.
Mine's a grain cart. That way I can keep the combines going and keep the tracks coordinated, and if the trucks don't keep me going, I don't keep the combine going. If he doesn't keep the receiving end going, the trucks don't keep me going, I don't keep the combine going. It's a total facet. But also in his department, I say the risk management side of corn harvest is very important to us.
The combine for me is probably the most fun, the most enjoyable. You actually get to see the fruits of your labor as the grain's coming into the header of the combine and then processing into the grain tank. And some people, when they ride with me, they think, well, this is just about as easy of a job as you get. All you do is turn around, push a button, let the combine drive itself to the other end of the field, and the header height stays at where you have it set, and you don't have to do anything but make sure the auger stays over the grain cart when you're unloading. Well, it is a little more involved than just that, and I kind of take it as a compliment. It's a little bit like riding with somebody who's a pilot. They just make it look effortless, and you just don't realize all the steps that are going into it. But the challenge of getting the combine to do a good job of gathering and threshing the grain and separating the material other than grain and from the grain, so that you have a quality sample to deliver, making those fine-tune adjustments, and that challenge, so you don't have excessive loss in the field, gathering the crop up if it happens to be down on the ground for some reason. There's a lot more challenge there than it appears initially. So the combine's where I prefer to be.
We also were fortunate enough to speak with Wayne Lee about his business with Cattle Empire and large-scale consumer of our corn harvest. During the interview, we asked Wayne about his job and how they feed all of their cattle.
Well, first, my name's Wayne Lee, and I work for Cattle Empire. I work in the risk management department. We currently have 225,000 head of cattle on feed. We use quite a bit of corn. We use about 50,000 bushels a day, which would be equivalent to 50 semis or two circles a day. So we use about 720 circles of corn a year. And so, this year we had a little bit more rain, and so corn prices are a little cheaper, which will help our cost of gain at the feed yard. Like I'd mentioned earlier, we use about 50,000 bushels of corn a day, and so during harvest, we purchase a lot of corn from area producers, and we just take as many of those bushels in that we can. And then, during other parts of the year, we buy a lot of our corn from commercial vendors, which area farmers sell corn to commercial vendors like ADM, Cargill, and we deal more with those commercial vendors later in the year. But during harvest time, we try to purchase as many of those bushels as we can from area producers. Like I had mentioned earlier, I work in the risk management department. We have four people that work in the risk management department, but one of my responsibilities is to help Cattle Empire buy the grain that we need to feed the animals. So what we do is we go out there and try to develop a price where we feel like we can bid on this corn, and this is a price that we have on our website, so farmers can go and see what we're bidding on corn, or they can just call us and we'll kind of walk that through with them. Some of my other responsibilities are lining up scale staff and determining where we need to have the corn go, to which yard. We do have three different locations, and we currently have almost 1 million bushels of storage on site.